And so let's look at the C++ implementation of such a direct form 1 filter. So C++ of our fixed point IIR filter. So what is also how does it look like with direct form? So let's make this here nice and big. So we have here, that's our accumulator. It's a central part here. Obviously also again, obviously an integer number. And then we have here our input signal x of n. So let's see. Input again integer, so this feeds here into this accumulator here with this factor b0 here. Remember, these are integers, so they are scaled up. And then here we have our delay steps. It's known as direct form. It has two delay lines, one for the input and one for the recursive part. And so this one then is here multiplied by b1, and then this one is here multiplied by b2. And so far that's a bit like our FIR filter concept here. And then what we also did in the FIR scenario for fixed point. So we divide this here by our scaling factor. So we divide this here by 2 to q. And so here the 2 to q is the scaling factor for the coefficients. So they've been scaled up in the design process before, and then we need to scale them down here. So this operation is here usually done as a bit shift operation. Also the same idea what we had with the FIR filter before. So nothing dramatic here. So then obviously this is here the output y of n, again integer. And then here we've got the delay steps here, t. And this is here the multiplication with minus a1. And remember, integer factor scaled up. And then here we have here multiplied by minus a2. And remember, the a0 doesn't exist. So that's always set to 1. And so that's here somehow like our it's called this in quotation marks FIR part. And this is here our actual, also create quotation marks, because the whole thing is obviously our IIR filter. IIR or feedback part. And so that's our filter. So there's no much difference between a floating point filter, just this that everything is integer. These factors here, b0, b1, b2, so they're all scaled up. And then we need to scale this down here again. And so that's the only difference here. And our scaling factor is usually a power of 2, just to make it easy to scale it back. So let's have a look at the actual filter implementation. So that's here the filter implementation here. And so here we've got the constructor direct form 1, and it's getting all these coefficients here. So let's try to put that here both on the screen, so that we have it next to each other. So here we see that these are our input values here, b0, b1, b2. So they are put here into the constructor. Then we've got here the values a1, a2. So they are here. And then here we see here the q. So this defines here our bit shift operation, what we need later. So they're all nicely stored here in local variables, scaling factor, and these FRR coefficients, how I call them here, and the IRR coefficients here. And so if we go down here to our actual filter, so that's our filter operation here. And so we see that the input here, this input signal here, what's coming in, that's a short integer. And so that this here, the x of 0, so that's here. So the so-called in here, this here is 16 bit. It's a short int, our short int showing up here. And so now we've got the here. This is our accumulator here, out upscaled. So that's the accumulator here, and the accumulator is an integer. So that's 32 bits. Let's just move it back here, that we see the whole diagram again. And so the accumulator here in the middle, that had this one has 32 bits here. So that's an integer. And so we're sending in short ints into the filter, and then the accumulator is 32 bits. And so let's have a look at the operation here. So here we have first here these coefficients here, that's the input in coming here from via B0. So that's here our B0. Then we've got here the input B1, and then here we've got the input B2. So these MX1 and MX2, these are our delays. So we also can call this here. So that's our M_X1. So this one here, and then this one is here MX2. And then here we have our feedback pathway. So that's our coefficient A1, coefficient A2, and they're just getting the inputs here from these two delay steps, MY1 and MY2. And so that one here, this T is called M_Y1, and this one is here called MY2. And so with that we have dissected here the filter. As we see, it's very simple. So then the last bit is here the updating of the delay lines. So here these T's. So we see here the first one is here we are feeding the value. We are updating this X2 here. So this means we are feeding the value from this delay line into that one here. Then we do the same on the other side. So we're feeding this value into that one. And then the X1 here gets this new value from the input. And the Y1 gets this new value here from the output. And then we just return it.